Miss Courtland!
Miss Courtland, please.
This way, Miss Courtland.
Raise your right hand. Do you swear the evidence you're about to give in this case before the court is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Now, we want you to tell your story frankly and without fear. Did you ever hear Mr. Scorpio discuss Mr. Rogers?
Yes.
When?
It was the night of Mr. Rogers' death.
What did he say?
He said he was going to kill Mr. Rogers.
Do you know to whom he was speaking?
No. The man never answered.
Did you warn Mr. Rogers?
Yes, I followed him to tell him.
I object, Your Honor. On the grounds that calls for hearsay.
Objection sustained. Drag it out.
Miss Courtland, do you believe that Mr. Scorpio killed Mr. Rogers?
I have every reason to believe it.
I object. I request both the answer and question be stricken out.
Objection sustained. Strike them out.
That will be all for the present.
Miss Courtland, if you please. I'd like to cross-examine the witness, Your Honor.
You may proceed.
I've known Miss Courtland for a good many years. Casually, of course, but long enough to know that she's at all times truthful. So I expect a frank and honest reply to a few very simple questions. I think I heard you say that you resided at 118 Park Drive?
Yes, the Clarendon Arms.
Oh, yes, yes. What yearly rental do you pay in that apartment?
$20,000.
Rather an exclusive neighborhood. You were in Mr. Scorpio's rooms the night you say you overheard this threat?
Yes.
You drove there in your limousine, didn't you?
Yes.
A gift from Mr. Scorpio?
Yes, sir.
But not the first gift he'd given you?
No.
Pardon me. May I ask, that 8-carat square-cut diamond you're wearing, that is an engagement ring for Mr. Scorpio?
No, we were never engaged.
Well, did you ever, that is, in the presence of witnesses, ever protest any real affection for Mr. Scorpio?
No, I loathed and despised him.
Well, I'm very sorry if I've said anything to upset you. Of course, to be compelled to accept gifts aggregating $100,000 from a gentleman one loathes and despises, that naturally puts one in a very unhappy frame of mind. But you were engaged to Mr. Rogers.
Yes.
Well, did you ever, that is, in front of witnesses, profess any real affection for him?
Yes, I loved him, and I wasn't ashamed to say I loved him. That's why I warned him. Oh, if he, if I...
Yes, thank you.